Good morning, guys. I'm going to try to also sound smart this morning, but this was very exciting. A giant watch party that scientists from all over the world, they tuned in for this because, well, this is a historic moment. And I have Dr. Michael Ressler. He is an astronomer and a scientist here at JPL. You also saw these images for the first time this morning. Correct. What was your reaction?
My first reaction was relief. I've been working on part of JWST for almost 25 years. And so as someone who helps build instruments, did it work? And so I can say very confidently, yes, it works, and it works really, really well. And after the relief was, you know, really kind of a sense of wonder. You know, these images are just that much sharper and that much more sensitive than anything we've had before. So it was a fascinating morning.
Definitely fascinating. You know, for the folks at home, what did we see today? What is today all about?
So today is really just the beginning of what JWST can do. The images that were revealed today were all taken within about a week's time. And so you can imagine if this is what we can do in a week, if this works for 20 years, there'll be a lot of really fascinating stuff to come out.
So first up, we want to show you the image. This is the Carina Nebula. This is where stars are born. This is pretty fascinating. Explain that.
Yeah, so stars form in these clouds of gas and dust. These clouds are orbiting within our galaxy, and over time, gravity will pull things together and form newborn stars. If you have newborn stars, that means you also have newborn planets. And so by taking images of these dust clouds, we see the stars. We can also take spectra, which allows us to break down the light and understand what material is there. And so we'll start to see molecules. We'll see things like water and carbon dioxide and methane. And the interesting thing to me is these are all the building blocks of life. And so it gives us a sense of this is where stars are forming. This is where stars like our sun form. And if we have the same building blocks where these new stars are forming that look like the building blocks of life on Earth, maybe
it's possible there is life elsewhere. That's the main question this morning. So let's talk about the James Webb Space Telescope. This is the technology, the new technology that's giving us access to these images, these very deep images into our universe that we've never been able to see before.
Yeah, so the observatory itself is 21 feet across, the primary mirror that gathers the light. And then there are four instruments. MIRI mid-infrared instrument is the one that I helped build. There are also three near-infrared instruments. And together, these work to take images and the spectra that I mentioned and allow us to explore the universe in new ways. These are similar to things that have flown before. The Hubble Space Telescope, of course, you know, the observatory that everybody knows and loves. Spitzer Space Telescope was an infrared telescope that launched about 20 years ago. It was one of our forerunners. And now we're just taking the next big leap from those. So we're much more sensitive, we get much sharper images, and so it allows us to explore in a new way.
And this is all being made possible, and we learned this morning, through gravitational lensing. What it's essentially doing is that it's mirroring the images from these galaxies, allowing us to see what these galaxies look like billions of years ago. How do you explain that to someone that doesn't quite understand that?
Yeah, so that was the deep field image that was actually revealed by President Biden for the first time yesterday. And so the gravitational lenses, you know, act like magnifying glasses that let us see galaxies that are even more distant than we should be able to see. But the light from those magnified galaxies left those galaxies over 13 billion years ago. So just a few hundred million years after the Big Bang. So we're seeing the galaxies as they were then. We're seeing how they looked when they were very young and still in the process of forming. And so it allows us to understand a little bit about how our own galaxy formed.
Just the very beginning. Dr. Michael Ressler, thank you so much for joining us this morning. You know, Frank and Jess, this is just a reminder of how tiny we all really are. So much we don't know, but so much we have the potential to learn about. So we'll send it back to you.
And a reminder of the wonderful people at JPL who are just doing work every
Brilliant
day that we drive by and we see the beautiful
They're complimenting
facility.
You and how smart you are.
Yes, we just love all those people.
Yes.